Everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Asmita and I make videos about movies, books, maybe TV shows in the future, hopefully. And I've made one video on mystery, and I want to say that I make mystery videos as well, but okay, we'll say I make mystery videos as well. So today I want to start something new. I want to start giving summaries of the books that I read. So it's going to be kind of like an in-depth look into what actually happens in the book. So it will contain a lot of spoilers. So if you want to read any of the books that I'm going to be summarizing, please do not watch this video. And if you want to know, and if you don't want to read the book but you don't want to know what happens in the book, then stay tuned. So today we are going to talk about Looking for Alaska by John Green. I ventured into the world of John Green with Fault in Our Stars, and I absolutely fell in love with the way he writes, the way he describes romance, love in teenage years, and the monologues he writes, the inner dialogues people have with themselves, and like the letters he writes is amazing. I absolutely love it. So, and I also read Paper Towns by him, and it was again an incredible book. I actually like the way he describes his characters and like what happens, what goes on in their mind. It was a pleasant experience reading Looking for Alaska. So this book is told from the point of view of Miles, who lives in Florida, and he's shifting to Alabama to go to Culver Creek boarding school. And he's kind of like a shy, he's shy, he does not really take initiative. He's also described as this skinny kid who really does not have that much confidence in himself, and he hasn't done that much in his life. And he figures now is the best time, go to boarding school and have some adventure and like, you know, make the best of my life. So he leaves and comes to the school, and he meets Chip Martin. Now Chip Martin goes by the name of Colonel, and he is the stark opposite of Miles. Miles is skinny and tall and not that confident, does not take initiative. And Chip, on the other hand, is short, he's sturdy, and he takes plenty initiatives, and he's very sure of himself. So Chip comes from a poor family that we get to know in the beginning as well. And he has this thing against rich kids who come from money. So this school is divided into rich kids and kids who are, you know, come from scholarship. So Chip is one of those. So they have this constant fight and this constant struggle where they're pranking each other all the time. The rich kids are pranking Chip. Chip is pranking, obviously, the rich kids. So Chip has this group of friends who consist of Alaska. Then there's Lara, and then there's Hakumi. Now these people are incredibly cool. Lara is from Romania. She has this funny accent. Alaska is, oh my God, she is a feminist. She is so sure of herself. She is confident. She knows these things, a lot of things. She gives these life hacks to everyone she can. And she's very, you know, she's also kind of very opposite of what Miles is. Even though Miles does not fit in with these people, he just, you know, is welcomed into the group, and he just becomes a part of this group. Now what follows is the journey he has with these people, and then the journey of him falling in love with Alaska. He falls in love with her, but she has a boyfriend, and you know, this whole thing goes on where he actually gets into a relationship with Lara, but he still is in love with Alaska because she's this idea of a person that he wants her so badly, that even though she has flaws, she's not always very happy, she's kind of sad, she has a boyfriend already, he does not let go of the hope that he might have a chance with her. So this book is divided into two parts. The first is Before, which describes his life with Alaska. And then there's After. So what happens is Chip and Alaska and everyone have like these crazy adventures. They do these crazy pranks. And one night, Alaska and Chip and Miles are sitting in a room and they're playing Truth and Dare. And out of nowhere, Alaska dares herself to kiss Chip. Sorry. She dares herself to kiss Miles, and then she makes out with him and he's very happy. And then she just gets up abruptly and she's like, I'm tired, but to be continued. And she gets up and goes out. Then she comes back and she's very, you know, she's disheveled and she's very frustrated and she's confused and she's just, you know, looking through things and she's very, very anxious. So they ask her what it is, but she's like, no, you have to help me. Just distract the headmaster. I don't know who he is. I think he's a warden. He's called the Eagle. So she's like, you distract the Eagle and I have to get out of here. But she's very drunk. So Chip and Miles obviously help her escape. And the news comes the next day that she's dead. Now, it follows Miles not, you know, really taking it that nicely. He's not coming to terms with the fact that she's gone. And he keeps on thinking about the fact that she said to be continued. Now, he does not know if she actually liked him or she just, you know, did it. Because she was kind of very, you know, independent and very free. So she used to make out with people. So he was like, am I one of those people? Or was she going to leave her boyfriend for me? Or did she really love me or something? So this, everything happens. They, you know, investigate everything. How did it happen? And the police says that, you know, she just came head on to the police car and she crashed into them. So they're like, maybe she committed suicide. Why would she commit suicide? Then they remember that she told them once that her mother had fits once and she did not know what to do. So she just sat there and her mother died and her father always, you know, blamed her for it. So they're just looking for any answers they can find, but they cannot actually know what happens. That is what the book is about, that no matter how much they want to know it, no matter how much they try, they can sometimes some things can never be, you know, described. Sometimes you can never get that closure that you're looking for. So in the end, they also talk to the boyfriend. The boyfriend is like, she told me that she was doodling something and then she just freaked out of nowhere and then she left, and then she obviously took some flowers and, you know, left in the car. So Miles finds these doodles of these flowers on her notebook that she was doodling when they were playing truth and dare and they were drinking, and it turns out that the flowers were some kind of a, you know, she was doodling those flowers, and those flowers were one of the flowers that she associated with her mother. And then they're like, maybe, you know, she got guilty and then she, because she forgot something and she was going to her grave and she just committed suicide. Maybe it was just spur of the moment, she did not plan it. Then they were like, no, how did she not plan it? How did she was that suicidal and we did not know anything about it. And then they're, you know, googling symptoms of depression and like self-harm and everything. And in the end, Takumi leaves and he writes a letter to them. And he says that he saw Alaska that night and she was very disheveled and very freaked out. And he asked her what was happening and then she was just crying and she was inconsolable and she left. So he thinks that it is what happened. That was the day her mother died and she was feeling guilty that she did not remember the day. She did not bring her flowers. So she just went, and on the way she felt she was overcome with so much guilt, and she might have, you know, those feelings of just not doing something for mother, that she just took her life. So it just ends on this note. And this book is actually, you know, very helpful. It tells you that you don't need closure, you don't need, sometimes there's no answer to something. Also, I wrote some things on here and it's just like, you have to forgive. You have to forget what happened. Alaska, even though a lot of people loved her, a lot of people looked up to her, she was the person you'd go to when you wanted to understand something, know something. She was super smart as well. But this one thing that happened to her, she could never forgive herself for this. And maybe that became her death. So maybe everyone should just try to forgive themselves and like forget it. And just remember, no matter what happens, there is a way out of this labyrinth. You're not gonna be in here forever. I really like this book. I gave this book 4 stars and it took me 2 days to read, because it was actually, it's not that dense, and the language I really, really, really love. There are these quotes in which Miles is like, you know, I'm in a love triangle with a dead person, and when will we get out of this labyrinth? Again and again, Alaska asks and stuff. There's Pudge, what you must understand about me is that I'm a deeply unhappy person. She says these things and still people are not coming to terms that she might have committed suicide. So yeah, that was looking for Alaska, and I highly, highly recommend this. And I know I spoil everything for you, but if you want to still read it, the language is beautiful. You'll just get the feel of it only when you read it. So maybe you should read it. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Bye.